we see that the vast majority of those food insecure and those in poverty live actually in rural area. And when we know that a direct benefit of social protection is poverty reduction, I mean, there is a clear need to therefore mobilize the broad wealth of FAO capacities to really act in the field of social protection, bearing in mind, as I was saying, that it reduces poverty, it takes people out of this vicious cycle of extreme poverty and deprivation, also that it contributes to alleviate inequalities, which is very important. Inequalities in the field of agriculture in the rural areas are big, and social protection definitely contribute to that. Then, of course, we are. You know that many of the conflict starts in rural areas. I mean, over conflict over access to natural resources, water, land, pasture, that sort of thing. We know that social protection also has the potential to promote social cohesion. From our perspective, social protection is more than cash transfer. It's definitely more than cash transfer. It has to do also with different aspects, be it health, water, etc. But also, from our perspective, there is an important productive dimension. We think that building on what we've been doing over the last years, and most notably this year in the current in the context of the fight against the potential risk of famine and against the drought, I mean, we think that we can mobilize all the tools that have been put in practice, including in our case we have done unconditional cash, we have done cash for work type of activities, we have been doing also cash plus activities by which we combine cash with the distribution of agricultural input or fishing equipment to really enable people not only to care for their urgent pressing needs and access the market, but also to re-establish their productive capacities. We think we can really build on that to transition towards a longer term social protection.